Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me right now is Natasa Strbo, professor at University of Miami and collaborator with Heat Biologics. Natasa, great to meet you. How are you?
Good morning. I'm doing fine. Thank you.
We have a lot to talk about today, mainly Heat Biologics preclinical results with this vaccine. But first off, maybe you can talk a bit about how you are collaborating with the company.
Yeah, sure. So we, my lab has a, I would say, long-standing collaboration with the Heat Biologics. So the vaccine technology that Heat has a license was originally developed at the University of Miami by Dr. Eckhard Podak, who was at that time my mentor, and I worked at the University of Miami for many years, and actually continued working on the development of this vaccine technology. And that's basically how we, it led to the development of the GP96 COVID-19 vaccine technology, and that's really where the Heat came, with a very strong collaboration with my lab in order to generate and preclinically test the vaccine in order to continue, of course, with the clinical studies.
So today you have published a scientific paper with preclinical results of this coronavirus vaccine. What did you see here? What were the results?
We thought that this is something that it's very important for the whole COVID-19 vaccine development, and we find very our data and our results very interesting, and I hope that will definitely bring something fresh into the in the whole arena of the vaccine development, showing that the cellular immune responses that are specific for COVID-19 can be induced through the vaccine, and particularly our vaccine strategy using secreted GP96.
These results that you see here in your scientific paper, how do they compare with other vaccine results?
So as I said, it's really, really important when we are fighting against COVID to engage both type of immune responses. So antibody as well as cellular immune responses. With that, I mean T cells. And there are lots of studies, clinical studies, and that are showing importance of induction of cellular immune responses in the fight against COVID-19. And what we are seeing right now with the vaccines and the studies that are coming from the preclinical as well as now from the clinical studies with the front runner vaccines, they're really focused at looking at the antibody responses, and I would say not so much about T cell responses, and we highly believe that induction of the T cell responses is equally important to induce the protective immune responses, and this is really where our technology offers something additional. And that's really inducing these cellular immune responses. And what we found in our study, it's not only systemic, so it's systemic induction of these COVID-19 specific T cells that are induced by our vaccines, which means we don't find these cells only in the blood, but what we hypothesized on the very beginning, that it's important to induce these cells locally. And in the case of a COVID-19, that means in the lungs. And that's what's really novelty of our findings, that we are showing the CD8 and CD4 specific T cell responses that are induced in the lungs and the airways, so right at the front line.
Natasa, congratulations on publishing these results here. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.